Hey guys, welcome back to the next video. If you're new to the channel, welcome. This is Richard for Welsh Tech, and today we have got the Enermax Lick Max Flow. This is almost 40 millimeters when it comes to the radiator, so very thick. Let's get into it, shall we? Okay, so this is the Lickma X FLO or X Flow. This is the Lickma X Flow or Max Flow from Enermax. Now let's get this out of the box and take a look at the overall AIO itself, so we'll be back. Okay, so we are greeted with the manual, so this will probably tell you how everything to install, all the bits comes with it, the covers, yeah, the overall installation. So now when we do this, now we'll get into the accessories. Comes with all the mounting brackets you need, the adapters, ARGB adapters, the SATA, so it's probably a proprietary cable, but yeah, that. It also does come with a little hub, which is quite nice. Not every brand does that. And then obviously, and we got the fans by here, which don't come pre-installed, but that's fine, completely fine. And they've got this weird like 6-pin or an, yeah, well, no, it's an 8-pin. Some weird 8-pin connector. And, of course, this one you can actually maintain with this, which is really cool. It gives you an actual jump off your PSU, so you can refill it, just like BeQuiet does. So let's get the AIO out and have a look. Okay, so here comes the radiator. And, yes, this is a massive radiator. The radiator thickness is 38 millimeters. That is redonkulous. This is huge. So that's gonna have a lot of cooling potential. So obviously the overall design, I do like this. It does come with a VRM fan as well. It's cool, I like that. It does come with pre-applied thermal paste, which is quite cool. It is a 4-pin, yes, first brand, yay. Then it comes with the RGB, and of course, and the fans, and they do come with this proprietary cable, but it's a weird cable. It's a, like this, it looks, yeah, it's an 8-pin. It's like a small version of an 8-pin, which is quite weird. I mean, I hope they don't draw that much power. I mean, no, they don't, no, the basic, oh, I don't know. I don't know about the connectors, but let's get to some of the specs. Now, what we'll do first of all is get through the sockets. Now, it does support LJ1700, 1200, 1150, 2066, 2011, 2011-3, that's the square ILM, 1366, wow, AM5 and AM4. Now, the radio dimensions are 400 by 120 by 38 millimeters. Wow. Yep, that's a big chunky boy. Now, the tube length is 400 millimeters. The copper plate on the bottom of this is copper, obviously. The tube is rubber. Now, the speed, this would be for the pump. The pump is between 1200 and 3000 with a ceramic bearing. It's got a 50,000 hour cycle. That's quite cool. And then when it comes to the VRM and fan in here, this between 500 and 3000 RPM. And that is a 0.24 amps. Now, as for the fans are 120 by 120, but this is an odd thickness. This is 26.8 millimeters. That's an odd thickness. I've never actually seen it with an odd spec for that. But yeah, 60,000 hours they rate it for, with a speed between 500 and 1800 RPM. The voltage is 12 volts. This current is 0.08 amp, with a rated current RGB LED with a 0.40 amp, and the airflow is 58.03 with a stab pressure of 2.4 millimeter H2O with a noise level of 23.46 decibels, and it's an 8-pin connector. I don't understand the thickness of this, but I guess it needs it. But yeah, right, so let's get this now on the test bench and have her see if this big thick rad and these fans can dissipate at 200 watts. Let's have a look. We'll continue to watch. Okay, so we start off first of all with the standards, which will be here. There is four of them, and these are just, this is for AMD specifically. So what you want to do is just screw it in. Now, when you tighten the block down, it will tighten these up, so you don't have to worry about screwing these down really tight. Just finger tight and you'll be fine. And that's done. And then here comes the bracket. Now, the bracket obviously is going to really depend, but what you want to really do is see where the bracket goes. Is like this. So you want to turn around like that, and it will just slide in just like that. Now, thermal paste is applied. Now, what you want to do is place it down, both in all corners like this. Now, what you want to do is press down a little, just so it stays in position. Then, you get these by here. Now, what you want to do is one side first, just finger tight, just so it stays in position. Same thing this side. Same thing, just like that. So I want you to do that on four sides. Just finger tight, first of all. Okay. Now, what you want to do is a crisscross pattern. So, start with the first one. Just tighten it down a little. Then you want to start from this side, like this. Like that. Then like that. Like that. Now, it's fully down. All you do is really just all the way down till this stops turning. Right. So now, we get to the cables. Now, this is the 4-pin PWM. This will be for the pump. And this one then, of course, is for the RGB around and in the little VRM fan. Now, first of all, I'll show you the ARGB. Then I will show you the pump. And then I will show you the fans. Okay. So, that but there is a ARGB header. Now, it will say, a lot of headers do say 5 volt. And then some of them will just say LED. It all depends on which one you actually get. So, let's get to this now. And it only goes in one way. So, as you can see, like this. Like that. And then all you do then is you just put it in. Bend the cable a little. There is a little bit of give to it. So, you'll be fine. And then that's it actually for ARGB. Now, for the pump, now I've said this in previous videos. Now the AIO pump header, as well as a CPU header, will be located in different areas on depending on what motherboard you buy. MSI, they tend to do it more up toward here with both of them. Gigabyte, I've seen them do this type of style. ASRock do it more of at this side toward the memory slot, but a lot of the brands do it where both headers are very close. So what we want to do is grab the ARGB or the pump header and put it like this, like that, and that's it, pretty much it for the pump. So as you can actually see right there in the corner, that one, that is the PWM header for the CPU. So this is the fan connector, which is a 4-pin, which is fantastic. Now what you want to do is connect it up just like I did with the AIO pump, and once it's connected, then you'll be able to control the fan. So wait and see this. And that's the header done. Sorry you can't really see it, but it is plugged into the CPU connector or the CPU header. So as to the installation, that's pretty much it. Okay, so when it comes to the overall system I used for testing, it is my AMD Ryzen 9 7900. It's got a Sapphire B850 motherboard. It's got 32 gigs of DDR5. It's got an RX 7800 XT. It's got a 2TB NVMe Gen 5. It's also got a 1000W cooling power supply, and it's housed in the B-Quad Chatterbase 800FX. Now, when it comes to the overall testing methods, it's the exact same way, exact same testing I do every single time. Cinebench, Blender Pavilion, Blender Classroom, as well as 3D Mark Super Test. Now, 50 and 100%. Let's start with 50% and then we'll go on. So, for the power draw, when it comes to 50%, the power draw at high was 181 watts with a low at 169 nice watts. The CPU clocks were high at 5.4 and low at 5. Now, for the Cinebench R23, the idles were 31 with a max of 84. Blender Pavilion idles 31 with a max of 82. Blender Classroom idles 31 with a max of 82. And 3D Mark Super Test, the idles are 31 with a max of 75 Celsius. Now, when it comes to the 100% fan speed, the CPU power draw was actually higher at 181 watts. And the low was actually higher this time. It was at 176 watts. And the CPU clocks were actually higher. The high was at 5.4 and the low was at 5.1, so you're actually gaining performance there. So for the Cinebench R23, the idles were 32 with a max of 81. Blender Pavilion idles 32 with a max of 78. Blender Classroom idles 32 with a max of 77. And 3D Mark Super Test, the idles were 32 with a max of 69 Celsius. Okay, so what I'm going to do by you now is I'll show you a graph. I'll put up a couple of AIOs I've tested, ones from like Gigabyte, Be Quiet, as well as Thermalright. I'll put up a couple of 360s because this has got such a thick radiator. It's, well, I mean, the performance is going to be obviously there because it's a very thick radiator, and that's going to saturate the heat much better than a normal traditional 360. So what I'll show here is going to be graphs showing this when it comes to performance, and this is going to actually show you when it comes to the overall thermals. This is actually one of the top. It's not the top, but it's definitely one of them, and that's going to show you in this graph. It does beat some of the AIOs from like Thermalright as well as other brands, so make sure you continue to watch. Okay, so what we'll start with first of all is what I actually like. Now, first of all, I like the overall thickness of the radiator. I think that in 2025, I think brands should try going a little bit thicker because it does help with saturation when it comes to the heat. Now, I like the overall RGB illumination on the fan as well as the VRM fan. It does look very, very striking, especially the overall color. It looks really nice with red. The blue looks very, very nice. Now, I like the overall mounting mechanism. I do prefer a 4-point mounting for AIOs because it does give you that perfect mounting pressure. Now, saying that, this does perform very well, and I'm telling you, it's mainly because of the thick radiator. That's going to saturate so much heat, it's really bonkers. Now, things I'm not exactly fond of. I do not like the proprietary cable. I think this little eight pin, it's not needed, especially in this day and age. A standard 4-pin PWM and ARGB would be just as good. But obviously, these fans obviously are higher end, and these are more of a static pressure fan. These do push a lot of air. I will say that, especially for this thick radiator, and with their newer versions of their AIOs, I hope they've changed this kind of cabling. Yeah, it looks okay for like the cable mess, but I'm just not fond of the massive connectors. That's pretty much it, actually, when it comes to like what things I'm not actually fond of. Other than that, I think it's a very good AIO. The price of it is a little bit steep, I'd say, for an AIO, especially in 2025. It is £100. Now, whether there's better options out there for your money, that I'm going to leave up to you. And I've definitely covered a lot of different brands on this channel, so you will know that there's a lot of different options out there. But what I'm going to say is, if you want a really good performing AIO that has a thick radiator, that the RGB is very, very nice, and that it does have a 4-point mechanism for the pressure on the CPU for mounting, then this is definitely a recommendation for me, because I do really like that four-point mechanism when it comes to the mounting, because it does help with pressure on the CPU and it does help with better spreading when it comes to thermal paste. But whether you agree with me or not, that's going to be really up to you. Now, I'd like to say a big thank you to Enermax, and I hope to continue working with you guys in the future. Now, as for future content, I've got another AIO here. I've got stuff here from other brands. I've got a monitor, stuff like that. I've got loads of stuff here. So make sure you subscribe to the channel. And as always, I hope you guys have a fantastic week and weekend ahead of you. This is Rich for Welsh Tech. Goodbye.